Welcome back in the last chapter of our four-part introductory webinar. In this chapter, we will review the most frequently asked questions regarding the use of the UroDapter. A common question from clinicians or patients unfamiliar with the UroDapter is whether it can be used in both male and female patients. And the answer is yes. The UroDapter is designed for use with maximal efficacy in both sexes. The detailed step-by-step instructions and animations for both male and female patients are available on the app.urodapter.com website. What type of syringes can I use the UroDapter with? This is an important question, and to answer it, we need to understand the types of syringes available on the market. There are two main parameters of syringes that are relevant to our discussion. The first is the size of the syringe. Sizes range from 1 milliliter or cc to 100 milliliter or even more. A 100 milliliter syringe is quite large compared to those used for blood sampling or intravenous injections. And typically 20 or 50 milliliter syringes are used for intravesical instillations, and the UroDapter is compatible with all syringe sizes. The second important parameter is the type of the tip. Most syringes have Lua slip or Lua lock tips, which are compatible with standard needles. With Lua slips, the needle can be attached to the syringe simply by pushing or slipping it onto the syringe tip. With Lua locks, the needle's base end must be twisted onto the syringe tip. Lua locks, for example, are used in intravenous cannulas to ensure better stability and a secure connection to the connecting tubes. In some syringes called eccentric, the Lua slip tip is positioned at the edge of the syringe to provide a better positioning for surface veins or artery injections. And the final tip variant is the catheter tip, which is larger than the Lua tips and compatible with catheter or gastrostomy tube connections. These are mainly for flushing or cleaning catheters or tubes and are found on larger syringes, like 100 milliliter or above. The UroDapter is compatible with all Lua slip, Lua lock, and eccentric tip syringes. The only syringe type it is not compatible with is the catheter tip type, which are not typically used for intravesical drug delivery. So in summary, the UroDapter can be used with any syringe size, provided it has a Lua lock or Lua slip tip, with the common sizes being 20 or 50 milliliters. I experienced some leakage of the solution in female patients. Is this normal? User experience indicates that with the correct technique, the incidence of leakage in female patients can quickly drop below 1%, and there is absolutely no leakage in male patients. However, due to the UroDapter's simplicity and logical design, new, inexperienced users who are unfamiliar with the device may attempt to use it without understanding the proper technique. And simply inserting the UroDapter into the urethral opening and pushing the syringe could lead to unsuccessful attempts. Despite its simplicity and ease of use, the UroDapter is a medical device that requires some practice and proper technique for successful application, just like any other medical device. For instance, the insertion of catheters, especially in male patients, requires substantial practice by healthcare professionals. In many regions, nurses are not even permitted to insert catheters into male patients. So consider this. The success rate of inserting a catheter without any practice or knowledge about the proper technique would be extremely low. Therefore, it is important to emphasize that new users should first understand how to use the UroDapter properly by following the simple instructions and easy steps provided on the app.urodapter.com website. User feedback suggests that in the first few attempts, a 15-20% leakage rate is normal for female patients, and this rate can be quickly and rapidly reduced to 5% after approximately 10 instillations and further to 0.5% with some additional practice. Can I use the UroDapter to drain urine from the bladder? No. The UroDapter was designed to replace the catheter in case of bladder instillations, but not for draining the urine from the bladder. Therefore, it's not suitable to replace the catheter for the purpose of urine drainage. There are two questions regarding residual urine that frequently arise. Should I check for residual urine prior to each instillation in a patient? And can I use the UroDapter in case of significant post-void residual urine? Post-void residual urine, or post-void residual volume, is the amount of urine remaining in the bladder after a voluntary urination. Normally, post-void residual volume is below 50 ml in 90% of the population. A PVR between 50 and 200 ml is considered significant, and anything above 200 ml is classified as urinary retention. In this case, most protocols recommend the placement of a urinary catheter. Now, significant PVR or urinary retention is more prevalent among elderly men or patients with lower urinary tract or neurological disorders. The presence of post-void residual urine is typically assessed with a quick bladder ultrasound after urination. Alternatively, a catheter can be inserted after urination to measure the drained urine. Assessing the presence of residual urine is necessary only at some point before the first instillation. The patient should be instructed to empty their bladder in the toilet, followed by a post-void ultrasound to evaluate any residual urine. For the majority of cases without significant post-void residual volume, the UroDapter can be used without any subsequent PVR checks. Patients are simply advised to empty their bladder in the restroom before each instillation with the UroDapter. In the minority of cases where patients have significant PVR, the UroDapter is not ideal for bladder instillation. However, it can still be effectively used for urethral treatments or diagnostic purposes. And with this, we have reached the end of this introductory webinar. We covered in detail the principles behind the UroDapter, its proper use, the main indications, and we also addressed some of the commonly asked questions regarding the UroDapter. If you have any questions or would like more information, please do not hesitate to contact us at mail@urosystem.com and we will get back to you quickly. Thank you for your attention.